Previously on Bessie.
You called me a Jedi. You know nothing. Mind tricks are not of the dark side. We prefer Force. Better. This is what I need.
Well, Vader, explain. What has happened now?
I arrived on Simoon 1 to begin the negotiations with the Hutt envoy over securing his resources. I found it under assault by rebel forces. The rebels were posing as the envoy and used it to infiltrate the moon. They tortured the Overseer into revealing the base's codes, then attempted destroying the core reactor. They had a certain success.
This is a considerable setback to our production. What of the Overseer?
I brought Agadain with me. I thought you would like to hear him yourself. We are ensuring there is nothing he is hiding. And then be sure, Overseer Agadain will not fail us again. The rebel agents troubled me. They...
Enough of them. Let us talk of failure. The Overseer will not fail again. But what of you, Vader? We kept the skeleton of the Republic for nearly 20 years while the Death Star was constructed. 20 years, my apprentice. All that planning is now a layer of dust orbiting around Yavin. Now, we no longer have the Senate to hold order. We do not have the Death Star to force it. Our greatest weapon is gone. Our production is in ashes. We are besieged. In all these years, we have never skirted closer to disaster. Thanks to you. You tagged the rebel ship with a homing beacon, then let the rebels escape with the Death Star plans. Deliberately.
I take responsibility for my actions. But I was not alone in my failings. The arrogance of the weapon courted disaster. Even the power of that space station is nothing compared to the Force.
Enough, Vader. Yes, Tarkin, Muti, and the others share the blame. But you are the only one still living to suffer my anger. You, an isolated survivor of the greatest military disaster in all my empire's history. Oh, you are truly the chosen one, Vader. Chosen to be the one responsible.
I will make it right. I will crush the rebels.
No, I think not. You think yourself so clever, but have proved yourself a blunt instrument. Far better to be wielded than willed. Tage always argued against the arrogance of the Death Star as a sole weapon. He alone was properly wary of the Rebels' threat. While the second Death Star is constructed, his philosophy must be dominant. It was lucky he left the station before its destruction to return to his beloved fleet, or I would have no one I could use. He is to assume primacy. You will act according to his will. But first, you must finish your dealings with the Hutt. If he cannot bring an agent to the core, we must go to the Outer Rim, We have no time to open conversations with the Crymore or any of the other crime lords. He will expect you in 2 days' time. Make the deal.
I am not accustomed to haggling.
Then it is time you had some practice. It is a passing phase we must endure. Eventually the Empire will claim the Outer Rim. It is not without precedence to go to the periphery to secure the center. Besides, Lord Vader, a trip to Tatooine, I'm sure it will be sentimental. Ah, yes. Good. I was expecting you.
Who is this, Master?
No one you need know.
Are you trying to hide something from me?
A Lord of the Sith asking questions and expecting them to be meekly answered? You are a poor apprentice if you think so. Is there anything else to report? Then go, and do not fail me again.